Prophetess Sutton coming to you today here on February 14, 2016. And I'm coming to you just to let you know that if no one has told you today that they love you, allow me to be the first to say that I love you in Christ Jesus. Love is never a one-day event, but it's a lifetime commitment. To many today, what they call Valentine's Day, I call God's Love Day. It can be an onset of depression, you know, not having a mate in your life to share love with on this special occasion. It may make many of you sad. It may bring about low self-esteem. But I do want you to know this. To all the single men and women who may not have received the rose, you may not have received the card, you may not have received the call, you may not have received an Instagram, you may not have received a Skype, you may not have received any love or affection on today, I want you to know that I love you, but God loves you more. I want you to love one another as Christ has loved us. Now, single people, it can truly be a blessing to be single. You know, it is in your singleness that you get to know Jesus and you get to build an intimate relationship with him. Amen. Now, during this time, become the king and queen who will love to bow down to and become submissive to. Ladies, become the queen. Which your king will hold out the scepter to, amen. Always remember who God has for you is for you, amen. Just tell the Lord, give me you. Everything else can wait, amen. Wait for your kingdom, queen, a king. But in the meantime, tell the Lord, just give me you. Everything else can wait. And you know, I want to, you know, discuss a bit of scripture with you. Because the Bible says that there is no fear in love, but perfect love casteth out fear, because fear hath torment, and he that feareth is not made perfect in love. So when you have fear of being with someone or caring for someone, it's not love, hallelujah, because there is no fear in love, hallelujah. When I think about love, I think about how Jacob loved Rachel, hallelujah, how he worked for 14 years just for Rachel. And then when I think about love, I think about how King Solomon loved, and I do believe with all my heart that the woman that he was writing about in the poems in the book of Psalms was Queen of Sheba. And I think about how he wrote an entire book of poems with this woman whom he loved so. And I think about how the Queen of Sheba was so drawn to the King of Solomon because of mere destiny. Many of you are going to be drawn to the one who God has chosen for you to love because of destiny, because God has a purpose and God has a plan for you to fulfill his purpose in the earth realm. Hallelujah. Many times when we get with mates or we find someone who loves us and we love in return, we think it's all about us. We think that love is about us, but that love is not always about you. It's all about Jesus. It's all about getting performing the will of God in the earth realm. Hallelujah. When I think about love, I think about how King Ahasuerus, some of you say King Ahasuerus, some of you say King Cyrus, you say tomato, I say tomato, hallelujah. But I want to talk about how King Cyrus, how he loved Queen Esther, hallelujah. I look at the story of Esther and I look at how not even many months before she became queen, that there was another queen by the name of Vashti. Hallelujah. Everybody doesn't pronounce it that way, but that's the way I pronounce it, as Vashti. And Vashti and the king were having a party on the same night. And the king's court wanted Vashti to come and dance before them. Hallelujah. And the king sent for Vashti, and Vashti said, I'm not going. I'm having my own party. Paraphrasing. Hallelujah. So therefore, she lost what respect, and she lost her queenship because she would not obey the king. She would not come before the king and dance before the king. But then we have here one other queen by the name of Queen Esther. Hallelujah. I think about Queen Esther and I think about her destiny. How when she came before the king and had not been summoned. You see, you can't go before the king without being summoned. When you come before the king has to summon you. If you come before the king and you have not been summoned, the protocol was death. Hallelujah. But the queen knew her purpose. The queen knew she had to make a move. The queen knew that it was now or never. The queen knew that because of the love she had for the people, that she had to make a move. So therefore, she went before the king without being summoned. And because of the love the King Cyrus had for Queen Esther, he didn't listen to the elders. He didn't listen to his court. He didn't listen to the wise men when they said that the queen should be killed, or that anyone who comes before the king without being summoned should be killed. But the king held out the scepter. Great God Almighty, that's a preach within itself. Glory to God. But I didn't come here to preach today. I just came to encourage you. I just came to let you know that this weekend, I want you to think about what love really means. I want the love of God to fill you, that you may walk in power of his great love. I want you to know that the Bible says that love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous. Love does not brag, and it's not arrogant. Hallelujah. Love does not act unbecomingly. It does not seek its own. It's not provoked. It does not take into account a wrong suffered. It does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Hallelujah. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians 13 that though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels and have not charity, I have become as a sounding brass or a tinkling cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains, and I have not love, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, and I have not charity, it profiteth me nothing. Charity, which is love, suffers long, and is kind. Love envies not. Love vaunteth not itself, is not puffed up, doth not behave itself unseemly, seeketh not her own, and is not easily provoked, and she thinketh no evil. She rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. When I say love beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. Love never fails. Hallelujah. I say that again. Love never fails. But whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether they be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is part shall be done away. When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see through a glass. Great God Almighty. For now we see through a glass darkly. But then face to face. Now I know in part. But then shall I know even as also I am known. And now abide faith, hope, and love, these three. But the greatest of these, say hallelujah, the greatest of these is love. Let me tell you this, for God, he so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Now during this weekend of Valentine's Day, or what you call Valentine's Day, but I just call it God's Love Day. Well, I want you to really think about what love means. I want you to really, really think about what love is. Love is action. Love is not only word. Oh my God, my God, my God. I didn't even come here to preach. But I'm just going to give you a little more scripture. I just want you to know that God is love. God is love, and without love, you are nothing. Without love, you are nothing. Hallelujah. So I want you to know that you've got to love one another. You've got to share your love. You know, there's many different kinds of love. And I come to you today with the agape love, because I want you to know that I love you, and that And if no one else has told you they love you today, if no one else has given you a rose, a flower, a card, an Instagram, a telephone call, if no one has told you they love you, I want you to know that I love you. And I'm going to leave you with this thought right here. And I will always love you. I will always love you. Hallelujah. I love you with agape love. I love you in Christ Jesus. And may this day be a very blessed, happy, and joyous time for you. May God send you your king or your queen. It won't be long now. God bless you. I love you. Keep believing. Keep trusting. And keep the faith. Amen.